Let's create a custom dashboard comparing work order completion metrics for two of our maintenance teams. We want to measure both teams on the percentage of work orders they complete, as well as the percentage they complete on time. We'll start by taking the created versus completed chart from the work orders dashboard and adding it to a new custom dashboard. We also want the on time versus overdue chart. Now that we have the two charts that we want to compare, we can take care of the rest from the custom dashboard. Unlike the main dashboards, filters on custom dashboards are chart-specific. When we apply a filter to a chart, it only applies to that chart. This is what will allow us to compare these metrics by team. Next, we'll duplicate the chart. This one will be for the second team. Now we've got our side-by-side view of work order completion percentage for these two teams. Let's repeat the process with the on-time work order completion chart. We now have a team-level comparison all in a single view. Let's take a look at a second example. Another big advantage of custom dashboards is the ability to mix charts from different top-level dashboards. Let's say we want inspection failure, downtime, and cost reports for a piece of equipment in one dashboard. Inspection failure and cost data can be found on the work orders dashboard, while downtime data lives on the asset health dashboard. We'll pull charts from both dashboards into a new custom dashboard. When a chart is copied to a custom dashboard, the date range and any applied filters are carried over. In this case, the date range and asset filter that we applied on the main dashboards have been retained on these charts. Now, whenever we view this custom dashboard, we'll have a trailing 3-month report of the inspection failure, downtime, and cost data for this piece of equipment. By publishing these custom dashboards, we make them accessible to others in our MaintainX organization with reporting visibility. Once a custom dashboard is published, any changes we make to it are retained in a draft state until the dashboard is republished. To revert a custom dashboard to its last published version, we can simply discard the current draft. If we're not quite sure whether we want to erase our changes, we could copy them to a new draft dashboard before reverting the original